I told you the story about a guy who had no shirt on him, and people say, "Why don't you sell your land? And then you can buy your clothes and build a house for yourself." He said, "I'm happy like this." They said, "But you could have more clothes and a luxury house or something like that." He said, "I'm already happy." And do you think I would be happy if I have something more? No, I'm happy because I have nothing. Yeah,
That's
it's
true.
true like that. I told you when I was in Rishikesh, I was happy. Or when I was with the monks and nuns, my monks and nuns, and in some wild place, just have a tent and live from river water, yeah? And roasted potatoes and oranges and stuff, or buying something from the Aboriginal people who live there, who planted vegetables and stuff there, who were very happy. I don't know if they were happy. They look happy anyway, but I was so absolutely happy. More than now, that's what I can say, okay?
Yes, Master.
Yes, Master.
Yes, Master.
Rishikesh, India, living with just one samosa now and then, and baking my own chapati. Oh, I was very happy. Truly like that. I really understand that world, you know? If you don't have
Yes,
much,
Master.
you're happy. But the people, they always see the grassy greener on the other meadow, you know?
Yes.
That's the problem. It's not a problem about being poor. It's a problem about having rich neighbors.
Yes.
Yes, that is the thing. And then your mind starts to trick you. Oh, what if I have that? Huh? Oh, I have to do everything I can to earn money, to have this, to have just like them or better. See what I'm saying? It's a
Yes.
competitiveness within that begins to cheat you, and then you begin to be discontented. Otherwise, I used to, when I was young, I lived with many poorer people, and they seem very happy. Their
True.
houses are very simple. They earn enough money every day, like selling tofu in the market. With their own labor, they work together with a sister or family member, and then bring the tofu into the market to sell. You know the silky tofu
Yes,
Yes,
Master.
Master.
that you can eat. You eat with ginger syrup.
Yes.
Yes, that's all, and they're happy. Yeah, they don't have much in the house. They have just a few pair of clothes, but I don't see any ever frown their face like I'm doing now. Or shaking their head in despair. Truly, ignorance is bliss. Yes. Before I became a master, I was happier. I didn't know much. Truly, I didn't know much. I mean, I did know sometimes when watching TV, yeah, that the people suffer by war and animals suffer, but not so graphic, not so deep and profound like now. And the more I know, the more I'm unhappy. Not because of my situation, but for them, yeah? It
Yes,
affects
Master.
me a lot. It gives me pain and sleeplessness. Okay, anything else before I'm on and on about the story of my life?
Master, for the beings in original universe, is there also such a thing as going within as a way of contemplation? And if there is any analogy to what we call here space?
No. No space. No going within. They are within. Okay? All the time. They don't know the difference between within and without. Not like we do. They don't have space. It's all space, and everything is transparent. Everything is spacious. Everything is no pressure. You see what I'm saying?
Yes, Master.
The reason we need more space is because we feel pressure from others. When our magnetic field clash and it's too close, or with the different levels of consciousness and energy clash
Yes, Master.
with each other, that's why people cannot feel comfortable with each other. And that's why husband and wife don't feel sometimes harmony within a marriage or family members, etc.
Understand.
Also influence from demons, yes. Over there they don't have what we have here. There's no way I can compare for you.
Yes,
Just
Master.
like somebody lives their whole lifetime in a tribe in Africa or Amazon somewhere, wearing no clothes at all, living by nature, and then somebody lives in New York. When they talk about skyscraper, they say, "What? What scraper? Scrap what?"
Yes.
And they talk about beefsteak. They don't know what beefsteak is. Yes? They might not even know what tofu is. You see what
True.
I'm saying? Tofu?
Yes.
Yeah. They don't know what clothes mean.
Yes.
The hat that you wear with the vegan are heroes. I say, what is in that? They never saw it in their life. Even if you describe it all your life, they won't understand it.
Yes.
There's nothing they can compare, okay? Nothing I can compare in this world to the world that's supposed to be yours in the future.
Yes, Master.
I wish I could. I wish I could. I remember a long time ago, I watched a film, George of the Jungle,
Yes.
or Modi,
Uh-huh.
the Tarzan of the Jungle, the little boy. Yeah. He's been an orphan since he was young, and the monkeys and the dogs raise him up, yeah. And they live with tiger and leopard and all that,
Yes, Master.
and swinging around trees.
Yes, Master.
And he had no knowledge of the other world besides that until he saw his childhood friend again, or George of the Jungle. He went from the jungle to New York or somewhere, and when he watched TV and people advertise it, coffee is a thing that brings people together. Yeah, and so he was in love with the girl who brought him there. They were not dating or anything, don't know anything. I said, oh, coffee brings people together. Okay, then he has to drink it a lot, you know? He just began to learn some English, saw the advertisement, so he drank a
Drink.
lot of coffee, hoping that the coffee will bring her together with him. Or he just, how you say, punching his chest and throwing leaves around as a sign of confessing his love, remember? The girl understood nothing. Yeah, we don't do that in New York, do we? Huh? No?
No,
No,
Master.
Master.
We don't punch in the chest and throw leaves all over to the girl that we love? Oh, she will bring you to an asylum. To the loony bin, huh? So there are different worlds within our world as well. Huh? You know that?
Yes, Master.
Yes. In an Arab country, Muslim country, when I went there, I covered my head. Okay? I cover with a shawl my head. Yes. But when I'm here, I don't cover all the time. We are not used to it. Okay?
Yes.
Only when it's cold, maybe when too cold, I cover. But it's not for that. I cover there because I respect their custom. Yeah?
Yes.
Yes. I want them to feel at ease with me. Like I'm not a stranger coming to make trouble or anything. Okay? I am you, like that. Yeah, so it's a different custom, you see?
Yes,
Different
Master.
custom. So when we are in a different country, I've been in Arab countries, so I know that. But if somebody had never seen an Arabian country or Muslim country, or we did not even have TV, if I describe how they live there, my people back then in Vietnam would never have understood.
Yes, Master.
And then even it could be dangerous, you know, when you say something that other people don't understand. A long time ago, it's a true story, eh? I told you before, but I'm not sure if it's translated. There was a king official. He went to France to study somehow at that time. He probably was the one and only at that time. Maybe he went there to study or also do some diplomatic connection or whatever. Yeah, at that time. At that time, we didn't have airplanes. A long time ago, we still had the king. Yeah?
Yes,
Yes,
Master.
We don't have any more. Yes. And then he went to France, and when he came back, he described the French way of life. Oh, the light, normally we still have oil lamps in those times, you see?
Yes.
Or wax candles. So he said, oh, we don't need all that there. The light comes from the ceiling, and the water comes from the wall, you know, the tap. Oh, he got his head chopped off. Even that dangerous. So not only the saints and sages who talk about heavens, which people don't understand. Even just the light and the water get the person killed. Other people told the king that, oh, he looked down upon you. You know, when you don't have respect for the king, then your head will go on holiday in old times.
Yes,
Yes,
Master.
or at least imprisoning. But this guy, because he told things that the king did not understand, and the whole court, royal court, did not understand, so they chopped the head off because his sin was like that. And in the old time, sometimes if it's worse, you could have even all your three generations had jobs as well, not just one person.
Yes,
Or
yes.
punished in a grave manner, or die or in prison or exile somewhere far away. Even just to talk about the truth. When people don't understand it, it's very dangerous for you. That's why most of masters, they live in obscurity. Yeah, it just happens that they cannot hide. When you are a 1,000 watt lamp, you know, it's difficult to dim it, to hide it.
Yes,
so people just know some way or another, or through the disciples. The more disciples praise the master, the more dangerous. So in the old time, many masters were persecuted. You see that?
Yes, yes.
In many different cruel ways, not just Lord Jesus alone. And their disciples were also persecuted, harassed or imprisoned or killed, or all kinds of things.
Yes, master.
Like that.
Yes.